Was that the first time?
Sorry?
First time you killed somebody. It always does something to you the first time. Then you get used to it.
I'm not sure I want to get used to it. That's him.
Miroslav Korda?
Yeah?
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions. Shit, don't just stand there. He's gonna get away.
Ah!
Hey, man, watch him!
Ah!
This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
Ugh.
I've seen the parents of all the victims. And all I've come up with is this telephone and a box of origami figures. All the newspapers are talking about Sean Mars, the kid who disappeared. I needed the rest. I haven't been sleeping well since the murder started up again. I can't breathe this goddamn humidity. Hope it stops raining soon.
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. Please, take a seat.
I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? You remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
No sender. Oh, nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation?
I'm sorry, Lauren, but that is out of the question.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
Listen, an investigation like this is dangerous, and I don't have time to play the bodyguard.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope, maybe your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners. Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go. What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? Bigwood tycoon from Kramer Construction.
No, his son.
You think maybe he's the origami killer?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers. Gordy Kramer, you stay here till I come back, okay?
Okay. Just let me know if you need me.
Hey. got me a new friend.
Stairs long enough for me to be able to slip past. Those two goons and me seeing Gordy don't mix. Gonna have to think of another way to get rid of them. Finding someone who wasn't smashed or doped up to the gills would be a miracle. And I need one right now. I'm at a dead end. Maybe I'll take a flyer on one of Lauren's ideas.
Whoa! You see that guy over there? Do you know what he said about you?
What'd he say?
The bastard! Ah, sort him out! You mother! Talking about my mother, you great monkey that cheats too? You're thinking, oh, you're a big man, I'm a bigger man. Ah, you go. Hey. Ooh, monkey, I'm talking to you, you big ape. What you think about my mother? You die, you get wild with me, my little friend. And you know who I am?
Mr. Kramer?
Shh! This is the best part!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
I don't know why, but your story just doesn't check out. You're giving me the crap. Now, tell me something I can't believe.
Very well. I'm the origami killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on their chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
Thank you. This is the old Pico power station. I thought it was abandoned. It might be a trap. I'd better be careful. Electrical condensers. Going by the sound of them, they're still active. Now where am I supposed to go? There must be a clue or something. The origami figure was in the form of a butterfly. So, am I looking for a butterfly?
Whoa! Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind.
Thank you. a dead end. I'm gonna die in here if I don't find a way out soon. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind.
I guess I don't really have any choice.